the topic today is just all the stuff that's coming up. It's also just a general Q&A. So now's the time. This is actually the first time I think I've ever had Leilani on a live stream. So now's the time to also ask her any questions about, like, if I'm real and if I'm a nice person, and the answer to all those things is no. So I'll just answer that right now.
You never talk over me.
I never talk over anyone. and I never criticize when you do this, when you want to say something right in the microphone like that. Anyway. All right. So we're going to, oh, Craig's here too. Emperor Palpatine. That is what I get called on occasion because of my red Kalos suit. All right. So here's what we're going to be talking about. Leilani's joining me because she is one of the folks, and the most important one, of course, in my life, but also at the symposium and at the AHR conference in Vegas. And so we're going to be going over what we're going to be doing in Vegas, what we're going to be doing at the symposium. We're going to talk briefly about the FRACCA conference and the educators conference. Those are sort of the four different places that we're going to be, but there's meetups that go around it. There's all kinds of different things that are happening. And I want to talk through what's going on, who the speakers are, all that sort of stuff. Now, as we go along, feel free to ask questions. We've got the YouTube Live folks up.
Am I from Sportland?
What? Someone's asking if you're from Sportland.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know. She could be a plant from Sportland. I met her many years ago. So if she was at Sportland, you would have already been there when you were like 13 and didn't tell me, like a secret agent. That's possible because she could be playing the long game with me. But no, Leilani is my wife. And co-conspirator, I think, is what we have on her business card. So here we go. All right. So we actually have a booth at AHR, and this is it pointing at it. So this is Las Vegas, January 31st through February 2nd. We have a booth, booth C6846. Put that in your day planner. Put that in your BlackBerry. Put that in your Palm Pilot, if you have one of those. And remember that. So we're actually very close to the, if you look just up above us here, this booth C67, whatever it is, the arrow's covering it, that is the Haven booth. So those of you who want to go visit Haven, formerly known as Zoa, which is a really great product and a sponsor of ours and really interesting to look at on the IAQ measurement side, we're going to be right around the corner from that. And another nice thing about where we are is we're right here by the concession stands. So I don't know if you can see that, but we're right by the concession stands. I'm going to get my little...
Let's see. So we can just eat all day.
We can just eat all day. Yes. Go. And well, I do that because that's because
you're getting old.
it's what we call geriatric bladder syndrome. I think is what that's called. Not judging, but anyway, try not to judge me. So anyway, we're right here. There are two different halls. There's the central hall, and then what's the other hall?
The north hall.
The podcast pavilion. Hold on. My voice is pretty bad, so I'm going to be taking lots of sips here.
While he's taking a sip of tea, check out this Venn we did on Bryan.
Venn diagram.
Yeah.
That was Leilani and John Oakes?
John Oakes and Marin.
Did Marin help with that too? Okay, yeah. I don't know if they can read it or not, but it's a Venn diagram on my life. It's special.
It's definitely worth
reading. Leilani, they said turn your audio up. It's just not a matter of your audio being up. It's a matter of you getting closer to the microphone, which we're working on here. Mic technique. Hi. There it is. Okay. All right. So we're going to have our booth. We're going to have the podcast pavilion, actually two podcast pavilions, which we'll talk about in a second, which are in the hall between the central hall. And I think it's the north hall, right?
Yep.
And those are going to have plexiglass sides. We're going to have interviews going almost constantly between us and several other podcasters. Eric Kaiser's here. Eric is actually going to be with us. So actually, let's go through that quickly before we move on from this slide, the different folks who are going to be with us at AHR. And I'm going to take a sip of water while you go over that. Do you remember who?
Well, I think we're going to have Nathan Orr, which is Brian's brother.
Yep.
Pretty much everyone knows who Nathan is, right? Danielle Wexler
is my assistant.
Pretty much the most important lady there.
Pretty much,
I mean,
does all of the work. So there's actually, yeah.
So there, really,
yeah.
She is. So.
Well, there's two reasons why, because people always ask, how do you get all this stuff done? It's like, well, you're looking at one of them here, and then the other is Danielle. Other than that, I really don't do anything. I show up for some podcasts, play golf.
Yeah.
You know.
And just tell us what to do.
Yeah, just boss people around all day long, all day.
So who else do we have? Eric Kaiser, which we've talked
Eric
about.
And we'll Rachel and his wife Rachel.
Yes. And we have Kaleb Saleeby,
Yes, Kaleb is going to be joining us. Mm-hmm. Really big into the IAQ stuff. Kaleb is actually going to be moving to New York City.
Yes.
Shortly.
I think he is there.
Is he there now?
Yes. Okay. And is Jim Bergmann going to be?
Yeah, Jim Bergmann. Jim Bergmann is going to spend some time at the booth. We talked about. I talked to him on the phone just a couple of days ago. He doesn't have a dedicated booth this year, so he is going because AccuTools doesn't have a booth this year, and so he's going to be spending quite a bit of time at our booth. We are going to have a full podcast set up there. So for anybody who wants to record, you know, if you're hanging out there and you want to record something with Jim, have it show up on the HVAC School podcast. It's just going to be a matter of mashing a button.
And just then mash we a button. Have Jessica Eagan, which is our lady service tech here in Claremont, Florida.
Yep.
At Kalos
Service. Service tech who happens to be a lady. You know,
yeah.
She just happens to be a lady.
She happens.
She's an amazing service tech in her own right.
Right.
You know, so yeah.
She's a lady. So it's super cool.
It is super cool.
You know, she's breaking the trends.
Yep.
And let me think, who else do we have there? I
mentioned Rachel Kaiser, Eric Kaiser, Kaleb, Nathan, Jessica, you, Danielle. That's it.
Yeah,
that's it. So that is our group. My schedule is really booked, but every time that I do have any free time, I'm going to either be at our sponsors' booths. I'm definitely going to be spending some time the first day, actually the first morning, I'm going to be at Refrigeration Technologies booth. Leilani's going to look up a few things on my calendar. But then I'm going to spend time at the HVAC school booth because it is both close to food and bathroom. So the thing I would encourage you to do is when you want to take a lunch, just come on down to our side, grab your lunch and just hang out with all the folks who are going to be gathered around at the booth. All right, moving on. Jessica says she's so excited and she just can't hide it. She's about to lose control and she thinks she likes it.
And Eli already got his ticket to the symposium. Yes.
Okay, sweet.
I'm not sure where you are from, Eli, but we're excited to see you there.
Yeah, where you're from, Eli. So the first day at AHR, so we're going to get into the nitty gritty here, as Nacho Libre would say, January 31st, which is Sunday. So that's the day before. If you're making it in early, we're going to have a meetup from 5 to 7. This meetup is brought to you by Diversitech. So they're picking up the bar tab. We're going to have for the first 40 people, we're going to be providing some drink tickets at Firefly Tapas Kitchen and Bar, as shown here on the screen. We will have those details leading up to it on social media. But if that's something that you think you want to do, maybe take a screenshot of this or write it down real quick. That is the Sunday before AHR in Vegas at Firefly, which is very close to the convention center. I think it's actually, I don't know exactly where it is. It's close to the convention center though. We try to pick something really close. So that'll be a great time to meet up with all the different influencer folks, people that you've always wanted to shake their hand and say hey to. So join us there for that. All right, moving on. So we're going to be doing a lot of stuff at the podcast pavilions. I didn't think I had this, but I do actually have this. So there we go. The podcast pavilions each day, we have different people who are going to come in and do interviews with us. This will be published on the main AHR website. If you go to the AHR website, to their homepage, you'll be able to find out more about the podcast pavilions, but they don't tell you exactly who we're going to be interviewing, I don't think. We've given them that information, so they may put it up. But especially on that first day, Pavilion 1, the system commissioning with Jim Bergmann, I think that's one you're not going to want to miss. We're doing one with Emerson. I'm actually going to be, I did just find out it's going to be with Andre Patenaud talking about CO2. I'm officially losing my voice here. Haven, I'm going to be talking with those guys. Mike Pastorello, Refrigeration Technologies, and then Brainbox AI, which is a pretty cool AI solution. That is the first day. Second day, I'm going to be moderating. This is one that I think you're going to enjoy. I'm going to be moderating a leadership panel. So these are the different leaders of a lot of the industry organizations. So ASHRAE, AHRI, HARDI, NAFA, and NCI are going to be there. And we're just talking about, you know, the effects of COVID on the industry, kind of how they see things moving forward. These are people who have a lot to say about our industry, and I'm going to be moderating that panel. So I'm not going to be doing a lot of talking, but I'm going to be asking questions and just kind of moving that along. So that will be something to join us for. And then on that same day,
you're losing your voice now. Now's a good time.
Now's a much better time to lose it than yes, HR, yes. So I hope we can gain it back by that time.
Oh, yeah.
All right. So that same day on Tuesday, I'm going to be doing a training presentation, just me talking, yakking away like usual, King Blobbity Blah style, on how to prevent callbacks and warranty returns. So
this one's cool. This one's going to be good.
I think it'll be pretty good. Yeah. It's going to be targeted. Whereas most of the stuff I do is targeted towards technicians, this is going to be targeting the entire industry stack. So manufacturing, distribution, technicians, contractors, in order to prevent these things for the end user. And we're going to be focusing on why that's so important. So why training is so important and how everybody can kind of join in to help reduce this. And I'm going to talk about, you know, kind of hot button topics like, hey, how about make your evaporator coils not leak? And how about putting capacitors that don't fail all the time, stuff like that, you know? So it's not going to be just targeted at technicians. It's going to be talking about the entire industry. A little bit more about the different leaders. And again, I want to pause here quickly to say, I'm yakking a lot here. If you have any questions about any of this stuff, ask as we go along. And if you have any other questions about anything else you want to ask, put them in there and we will answer them at the end. So this is also an Ask Me Anything session, or really an Ask Leilani Anything session. We're going to throat lozenge now. That's definitely going to be not gross. Hearing me suck on that. Leilani's really going to enjoy this. So anyway, so
you're going to pause now. Just let that simmer.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
This lozenge is really helping. Well, do you have anything to add that you want to, anything that I'm missing here so far that we should cover while I'm allowing my throat to, okay. Yeah. All right. So, this group, I've already kind of set up the outline for it. These are the things we're going to talk about. A lot of it is pretty high end, especially for contractors, people in distribution, that sort of thing. I think you're going to find it interesting. And just anybody, welcome to another episode of Terrible ASMR. The lozenge was a bad choice. We're going to stick it down here dip style. My friends from Groveland, Florida have done this for many years and been able to cope. So should I. All right. Then the, how to prevent callbacks and warranty returns, pulled a couple slides out of it. Just to kind of cover, we're going to talk about, customer communication side, commissioning best practices, the reasons why we need to address this problem, how to address it from a training standpoint in order to, or to just prevent it, because it's a major issue, especially when parts availability is getting far worse and shipping is more of a problem than it ever was. It makes sense for the industry to focus on this problem from top to bottom and actually invest some money and time in reducing these issues. Are we getting any questions over there? Are you paying attention to what's going on YouTube?
They're kind of talking together.
Okay, they're just talking to each other. Yeah, that's fine. All right, then on Wednesday, we have more podcast pavilion stuff. I'm going to be speaking with Carrier on Pavilion One, Field Piece. We have Rick Streaker from Packard. Rick is actually one of the really underrated educators in our industry. He talks a lot about motors and electrical stuff and all that, but he was at the symposium last year, and he's coming and actually doing 3 presentations at the symposium this year. And he's got really great information, a really great instructor. There's a lot of videos that have been put out over the years by Packard, and something to definitely check out. And then we're going to talk about Legionella management. It's sort of a big shift of topic there, but a very important one for people who do that sort of stuff. Eric says that Rick is a motor god. I'm not sure how one becomes a motor god, but I do think that Eric's probably right about that. He somehow accomplished that. All right, so this is just kind of showing the broad Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday at Podcast Pavilion One. You can see, you know, we've got some slots here, very highlighted, us. Then there are some others, and I'm sure they'll be fine as well. But you know, definitely check out the Podcast Pavilions. I think that's going to be a lot of fun, especially because the first time they did this was in Orlando. That was 2 years ago, and it was kind of off to the side. This year, it's going to be like right in the middle of everything. It's going to be absolute chaos.
There's going to be an intersection of both halls coming together.
Yeah, we're literally going to be blocking everyone's way. And so we're going to be like
forced to listen.
Yeah, it's going to be a giant irritation. All these podcasters taking over the convention hall, but it'll be a good time. Nonstop party. Second day, this is us too. You can see there's some folks who don't have a lot, but there's some good ones here. Mechanical Hub is going to be there. Those guys are great. Women Behind the Wrench, also great. Phil Zito for the kind of smart building, building automation systems type stuff is going to be there. So a lot of different folks that you're going to want to meet at the podcast pavilions. Our friend Terce Blissett, tool pros. I'm sure Brent Ridley is going to be the one there for that. So excited for all those folks.
Eli, what hopes that you feel better so that he can see your face without a mask?
Well, so that's the thing about AHR. AHR is going to require masks. So that's not an AHR thing. That's actually a Vegas thing. All throughout Vegas, all the casinos require it. All the public areas are going to require masks. So it's not going to probably be the place to try to get around that. I think they're going to be enforcing it pretty heavy. So going to be a bummer. But when we're speaking, they're not going to require us to wear them. It doesn't sound like. For doing podcasts, that sort of thing, they're not going to require us to wear them, but the audience, you're pretty much all going to have to wear them all the time. It's going to be kind of a fuss.
We've got another question of what's this about?
What is this about?
Yeah, just this whole thing.
This whole thing. This is, we are talking about everything that's going on. This conventions, conferences.
SAC 2.
Conventions, conferences, everything that's going on over the next couple months that we're going to be present at. And then also just an opportunity for you to ask any questions you want to ask. So I haven't done a live video in a while. And I decided to pick a time when I have no voice whatsoever. So that was, Bill says that I'm giving my wife COVID.
That happened.
Trust me.
A long time ago.
Trust me. There's a lot of sharing. A lot of sharing. Sharing is caring. All right. So the symposium, our training event, is coming up. I'm excited this year to not look as fat as I look in that picture. That is one thing that I've been working on this year. I think that's
pretty. That was
last year. That's an especially good one. That's an especially good one. Yes, this is Claremont, Florida, just outside west side of Orlando. All of the information for this, and actually, I'm surprised we don't have a link here for this, which is odd. That is hvacrschool.com/symposium. If you want to know how to spell symposium, it's right there on the screen. hvacrschool.com/symposium, February 17th, which is a Thursday through February 19th. All the best speakers and sponsors that we can think of are bringing in one place doing technical training wall to wall. We actually do have some more business content this year. We have two different business sessions for people. We have a lot of requests for that. And this is brought to you by AccuTools and True Tech Tools. They're the ones who came up big in order to help fund this thing to make it possible.
Yeah, we've got classes going in different places. You have breakfast and lunch is served to everybody who attends. Mm-hmm. And it's a fun and warm event.
Yes, it is.
In Florida.
So. Yes, it is. John White says that he hopes that I educate people about Alice Parker. Alice Parker is very hard to educate people about. I have actually talked about her and written about her. She was an African-American lady who invented a specific type of gas furnace, really kind of ingenious zoning type system, but there's so little information about her. We actually reached out to a bunch of scholars to try to get more specific detailed information, but it is tough to do, but definitely a big contributor to our trade. All right. So why attend the HVACR training symposium? Well, it's just one of the best places to actually connect directly with educators in our space, people who are thought leaders, manufacturers. It's a very small event and there's only 200 actual attendees locally at the event. And then we have a lot more virtual tickets. So if you can't make it in person, we do have virtual tickets available.
So you can see all the sessions. Last year, I think we had over 1,000 people.
Oh, yeah, on the virtual. Yeah.
This year, I think, and that was really last minute. So yep. It ended up being definitely worth their time. It seemed like they were happy with the virtual ticket as well.
Yep. So one big thing that a lot of people like about it is you do get 16 hours of continuing education so long as you take a full slate of speakers. So as long as you spend the full 16 hours. So for people who need to get there, Nate, either the virtual or in person can get you all 16 hours that you need for all 2 years. So for people who need to get their Nate recertification, that's a really great way to do it all in one fell swoop. It's just some of the names, Jim Bergmann, David Richardson.
We've got a question here about the symposium specifically. Is it hands-on stuff or is it more book stuff?
It will be both.
Give an idea a little bit about that.
It'll be both. So there will be presentations where they actually have equipment. We have demo equipment that they're going to be showing things on. For example, Craig Migliaccio, AC Service Tech, is going to be doing one on gas furnaces. We're actually going to have a working gas furnace going over it. On Saturday, which is the third day, we're actually going to have a working lab with a gas furnace and a heat pump where all day long people are going to be able to go in and put tools on it. So if there's tools you've wanted to use from our sponsors, Jim Bergmann's going to spend a lot of time in there going over Measure Quick with everybody. You're going to get a chance to use the TrueFlow grid from the Energy Conservatory is going to be there. So a lot of different things that you can do hands on there as well. And that's mostly going to be on Saturday. Let's see. Lunch, if you're in person, lunch is provided each day. So we're going to have lunch. I don't know. Do we know yet who our lunches are going to be? But I'm sure we'll have Chick-fil-A at least one day.
Yeah. We usually have a barbecue place.
Yep. Usually we have Latin food one day, barbecue one day, and then Chick-fil-A one day. And there goes my voice almost officially. So this will get interesting. All right. Symposium sponsors. A lot of the same people who have supported us over the years are continuing to support the symposium. AccuTools and TrueTech being the two biggest, Diversitech coming in at platinum. But we have Emerson, FRACCA, Fieldpiece, RetroTech, NAVAC, Milwaukee is coming in this year, which we're excited to be more involved with them. Refrigeration Technologies, Ultra Air by Santa Fe, formerly, Ultra Air by Santa Fe. Yeah. So they're going by Santa Fe branding, and then Ultra Air is the kind of sub brand. And then Rector Seal is also coming in and supporting the event, which is pretty awesome.
Agrees. What is at the symposium? He has been at the symposium every year. Somebody asked if Andrew Greaves was at the
Symposium. Andrew Greaves was at the symposium.
He will be coming this year as well.
Yes, he will. Yep. Andrew will be there. Chris Stevens will be there from AC Service Tech, Craig Miglaccio, Chris Stevens is also going to be there. A lot of influencers, the HVAC Overtime people, Advanced Refrigeration, the guys from Advanced Refrigeration podcast are going to be there. A lot of folks are going to be there. I extended invites to almost everybody in terms of the influencer community, podcasting community, YouTube community that I could think of who can make it. Now let's go over the schedule a little bit. So I'm trying to find opportunities for you to talk so I can give my you think I'm doing okay here?
I mean, yeah, you don't have to try so hard. Maybe okay. You just like, you
just know, calm down yeah, a little bit. Okay.
Maybe yeah. It'll feel better.
Just chill. Okay. Yeah. All right. We're just going to chill. All right, man. So,
hands-on activities, are they good for total greenies? Oh yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
There's no level of like knowledge that you need to have or experience to come to this or to benefit from it. And I think it's a great mix of beginners and advanced technicians and leaders in the industry for sure.
Yeah. There's a lot of, the symposium has a lot of building performance type stuff. So how to affect comfort, but the information that you get will benefit everybody all the way up the stack. So regardless of how experienced or inexperienced you are, you're going to learn something from it. But there's a wide range of information on a bunch of different topics. So, and you can kind of see here, I'm not going to go over every single one, but Ty Brandeman's going to be opening up. Ty is a really dynamic speaker. He's very inspirational, really great instructor. So he's going to open up the event. When people start coming in at 7 and get registered, get bagels and coffee. That's one of the best times because you get a chance to just kind of hang out, talk to everybody every morning, take advantage of that and lunch.
It's an indoor outdoor event. So when you gather and there'll be tents. So most of this is actually like partial indoor outdoor.
Yeah. It's mostly, even the warehouses, you know, they're in warehouses and they're fairly open, very high ceilings, kind of open doors, that sort of thing. Somebody asked, is there available tickets in person? I think there are a few tickets left. If you go to hvacrschool.com/symposium.
Can we like type the link here?
Sure, we could type the link here, but that's only in Zoom. We're not going to do that right now. hvacrschool.com/symposium. If you go on our website, it's right up there in events, and then there's the symposium dropdown as well. Then we go straight into, so everything here on the left side, that's the main stage. So those are kind of the big ones in the big tent. We have a big tent in the parking lot, and then you have some breakout sessions that you can also attend. This is probably going to shift around a little bit. We keep kind of adjusting it based on trying to get it as even as possible.
The timing for the speakers.
Yeah, timing for the speakers. It's tricky because not all speakers come in the first day. And so we have to try to figure it out. For example, this first, these first couple, it's like already a bummer because like all six of these I would want to go to, they all are really great. But you kind of got to make your choice. And the nice thing is that even if you're an in-person attendee, you still get access to the virtual ticket. So you can go back later and see all the ones you missed. So try to pick the ones you want to see in person, kind of your top, and then you can kind of go from there. Yeah. Neil says 10 a.m. is also a problem. Yeah. I think we're going to actually adjust that one. I think we're going to slide Steve Rogers to a different slot, so we have a little more variety, because those three are all really big building science topics. All really great speakers.
Wait, Neil had an opinion about that?
Yeah, Neil has an opinion. That's really surprising. There's a shocker. Neil Comparato, everybody, asserting himself and his thoughts. That never happens. All right, so Rick Sims is coming back this year. Those of you who attended Rick Sims' talk on conduxation know that he was like one of the favorites for the event. He's coming back. We have a new speaker, HVAC Mensch, and all of a sudden his name is escaping me. John Chavez is his name. He's actually been on the podcast a while back. He's going to be talking about VRF and ductless because I wanted more content on that. Russ King is going to be in person. Russ was virtual last year, but he's really great on the design side. And we've got Tony Gonzalez from Field Piece, Steve Rogers, Eric Kaiser, all really great. I'm really excited about Jordan Cummings, and it's not listed here, but Jordan's going to be presenting with Christian Baugh on VRF, and they're going to knock it out of the park on that. I'm sure those guys are great. It's just not going to be on this day where we have to move it because Jordan's coming in late.
The symposium event will be in Claremont, Florida, Central Florida, local to where we live.
It's at our office, the Kalos office. Yeah. All right. Jason Objute is going to be coming to the event for the first time. He's going to be talking about A2L refrigerants, kind of the phase out. You know, he's the expert on that topic, so we're excited to open with that. David Richardson's coming back. Ed Jonowak, who is now the contractor training director, I guess, for, I'm making that up because I don't remember exactly what the title is, but he's the big shot for contractor training at ACA. So he's going to be talking about manual S and some of the changes. Steve Rogers has a really great presentation at the same time. Once again, a tough choice to make. We've got a hold here that's actually being held for Don Gillis. He did just confirm we don't have his topic yet, but Don Gillis for Emerson is going to be there doing some training. He's always excellent.
Yes.
Jim Bergmann is going to be talking about vacuum shocker there. And then Rick Streaker's got a whole bunch. Another one that we're really excited about is Chris Mohaly from Regal. He is like one of the best instructors on the ECM motor side of things. On the ECM side of things. I know Eric Kaiser is going to correct me there. And he's going to be really excited to have him back. I'm also excited, as I mentioned, to have Craig back. AC Service Tech, the most subscriber YouTube channel on the internet. He lets me know it all the time. Actually, I want to find my plaque that he made for me to make fun of the fact that he has more subscribers than me. But
you have some. Anyway,
it's not worth it. I mean, I'll get upset.
There it is.
I'll start yelling. Oh, where is it? Oh, here it is. Yeah, this is the
last year's. I'm in Old South chat here. Asked about last year's presentations at the symposium. They're available, for 60 days after the symposium. So last year's presentations are not currently available.
Some of them are available on YouTube. So if you go back through YouTube, you can find them there. But
not the whole session.
Yep, not everybody allowed us to put them on YouTube publicly. They will all be available. This time we're going to try to keep it up for longer. We're looking at 90 days or 6 months because some people did miss out on that. But yeah, we gotta abide by the requirements of the different speakers. Some of them do not allow their stuff to be put on YouTube. Don't worry about me. If I die on camera, at least I'll be remembered. All right. Saturday, we clear out the commercial warehouse, so we don't have any presentations there. And that's where we do the hands-on session of the portion of the symposium. Let's see. Chris Stevens is going to be opening up. That will be really good. He always brings it really well. And yeah, that's it. Advanced refrigeration guys are going to be there. I'm excited to see them. they focus on more of the market refrigeration side. So they're going to be kind of representing on that front. We do also have a teardown class that, and I think I missed that one. Oh, Alex Meany is going to be there too. Hey, Alex Meany, there you are right there. If you wondered where you are in the schedule, there you are. Excited to have you. Let's see, where is that? Oh, there it is. Trevor Matthews, compressor teardown class. That's also going to be great. And this is kind of a new thing. We're going to have a Ask Us Anything panel. We'll take questions from the audience. So prepare questions. If there's ever anything you wanted to ask Jim. I didn't tell Eric Kaiser that he was going to be on this yet, so I need to ask his permission, but I figure he's probably down for it. He's usually down for almost anything. I was originally going to be on it, but I figured it'd be better if I just ask people who actually know more than I do. And that's that. Then at the end of the symposium, we have a meetup at Plant Street Market in Winter Garden. The meeting time is to be determined, but it will be after the event. So pretty much just head over there after it's done. And that's going to be brought to you by Measure Quick. So we're going to have some snacks, some drinks, all that kind of stuff. And there's a nice outdoor space, indoor space for everybody to kind of hang out and just get that one last shebang in before we all.
There will be free drinks.
Yes, there will be free. There will be free drinks for 70 people. So
first 70
that show up are going to get something, and then it may run out. And if it does, well, then that's why you have a credit card. That's what I always say. That's what Leilani always says about me too. That's why I have a credit card. Something like that. Anyway, are you going to be at the conference in March is something that Robert asks. Yes, Robert, and we are getting there. So there's two other conferences I'm going to be at and speaking at. So the first one is the FRACCA conference, which is the Florida version of ACCA. It's at the Florida Hotel in Orlando. I'm actually doing two presentations there, one with Jim Bergmann on vacuum, going over everything that's in the vacuum book that we updated. And then I'm also going to be doing one with my dad, first time I've ever spoken on stage with him. So this will be interesting. I don't think I'll be actually talking much, but we're going to be talking about ethics and business there. And then at the HVAC Excellence Educators Conference in Las Vegas, I'm going to be there speaking on, I'm actually going to be doing a co-presentation with Dick Wurz. We're going to be talking about different education styles for different ages and stages of technicians. Dick is the author of the, all of a sudden my mind is going blank here, Commercial Refrigeration for Air Conditioning Technicians book. And then I'm also doing a closing talk about recruiting and training the next generation of technicians. It's focusing on sort of millennials and Gen Z and how to get them into the trade and then how to train them and keep them in the trade as we move forward. So that is that. Now it's time for questions. So anybody have any questions about any of this stuff that I just talked about?
Or any of the stuff he didn't talk about?
Any of the stuff I didn't talk about. Yeah, anything you want to ask. What time is it? Yeah, see, we went pretty quick here. Let's see here.
Wait, it's 7:37. 30
minutes. Yeah, that's I guess that did take a little while. Let's go back to the
Milwaukee and Field piece at the symposium. What are they doing?
So all the sponsors are going to have tents. They're going to be bringing product out. They're going to be bringing good demos, allowing you to try out stuff. The True Tech Tools is going to have all kinds of stuff there. So True Tech is going to have all kinds of tools you can put your hands on as well. Let's see. More Jello, please. One of my favorite icons out there says, sorry, I'm late, man. You don't sound good. Yeah, I told you that right off the beginning. I'm sounding worse and worse. I brought Leilani on to do talking, but I can't help talking over people. So it's just getting worse and worse as I go.
Let's be honest. I don't have anything to say. a really random question. Have you heard of ACCA Manual C? I found an old book that says Manual C first edition. Never heard of it before.
ACCA Manual C. Nope. I don't know what that is. But I also honestly, other than kind of like the standard residential manuals, I don't know the manuals really well. There are a lot of them. A lot of them. Alex Meany might know. Alex Meany, have you ever heard of ACCA Manual C before?
manual C first edition. Actually, no.
Alex Meany hasn't either. So yeah, that's
a fake.
It might be fake.
If Alex hasn't heard about it.
Yep. All right. More Jello, please, does have an actual question, so you can read that.
Why does my vertical A coil leak down onto my filter, causing it to rust? It's a MERV 8 filter in a new Bryan-y Evo system, low static pressure, et cetera.
A lot of different reasons why that can happen. You know, I've seen cases where something gets on the evaporator coil and it drips off. So something that is causing it to drip. The thing to do in those cases is to take a piece of plexiglass and put it up and kind of just watch and see where it's coming from. But there can also be some weird, you can get strange currents, even just around the drain pan. They can cause it to pop out in different spots. So we always kind of use the plexiglass method to try to figure out what's causing it.
Omar asked what this video is about. Basically, Brian's going over the stuff that's going to be happening here locally with HVAC school and the coming AHR convention he's going to be attending. So he's going over some stuff that he and a lot of other people are going to be engaging in, and just kind of inviting on board to stay tuned to what's happening in the next month or two.
Yep. Joe Shearer is going to also be one of our panelists, and he is answering your question. Slant coil raining off on the off cycle. Yes, we do see that from time to time too. Yep. Yep. All right. If there's no other questions, then we're going to wrap this thing up. I am going to take this information, and we will put it into a an email, so you will all have it. We'll format this into one of our daily emails that you get, so all that information will be in one place. If you are interested in getting one of the final few in-person tickets for the symposium, go to hvacrschool.com/symposium.
Yeah, it is very limited space in person, so those will go pretty fast now.
And also you can, it is up now, so you can purchase the virtual tickets as well and get right in. We made it a little easier this year for the virtual. It's also going to be a lot better in terms of the visuals. Last year we had static cameras. So this year we're actually going to be doing some more active camera management in order to make the views a little better. So the virtual experience will be better this year. Is there a general email you have so we can contact you? You can try. My email is Bryan, B-R-Y-A-N at hvacrschool.com. Things about the symposium, though, I would request that you would, and this is actually on the site, I would request that you email danielle.wexler@kalosflorida.com, because she's my assistant. She's handling all those details. I get like about 300 emails a day, and so it's hard for me to get to all of those. But always feel free. If it's something I can help with, I will try to help. And that is Bryan at hvcrschool.com.
Yes, the virtual ticket is live for a few months. We're going to see how long we can get that to be available, at least 60 days, and hopefully maybe a little bit longer this year.
Yeah, we're targeting, I'm trying to get it for 6 months. It's just a matter of, it's a matter of hosting it for that period of time, because there is a cost involved with that. And we're already spending a pretty good amount and upgrading the video and some other things to just make the streaming experience better.
Geo says, hey, Bryan.
Yo, Geo, sup. I wanted to just kind of get that up here again, because the one thing that I think a lot of people do miss is if you do need Nate CEUs, it's a really great event for that. Because they're 16 hours. All right. So I think that's it for me. Anything else? Nope. Good. All right. Thank you all. Have a wonderful evening. And next time I am speaking, hopefully you will be able to hear me better. Have a good one.